Good morning. Well, welcome to my book talk. I'm going to share a book on Christian discourse by Soren Kierkegaard. Let's pray. Father, we thank you. We ask for your anointing and favor beyond measure, Lord. We would like to see your kingdom come. And as Soren has declared, Lord, that we would not want to worry about what to eat, what to wear, just like the bird that's flying in the air. Lord, help us, O God, that we may have this faith in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm very, 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 very excited that now we're continuing with Soren Kierkegaard book series. Soren is an awesome philosopher. I've been following him since when I was 26 years old. He was born 1813, died at 1853 at age 42, American age 43. He's the founder of existentialism. He's a philosopher. He was a theologian. The primary question he asks is how to become a Christian. What does it mean to have faith? And he insists that you cannot be born as Christian. You must be birthed as a Christian, not as a group. It is not a group activity, as an individual. He was considered himself as a Scots spy because he wrote a lot of these books with pseudonym because he did not want his reader to have bias about who he was, read it differently. So he would write with all these different names, Anticlimacus and all that. And so he truly was brilliant genius. And one time I was attending this church in London, Korean immigrant church. And basically the pastor was preaching about against Kierkegaard and consider Kierkegaard as almost like Antichrist. That really outraged me because obviously he never read Kierkegaard. Just reading one book, Christian Discourse, will prove that Kierkegaard, not only Christian, his entire life was spent on talking about what Christianity should be. See, the background of Kierkegaard writing this book is that Denmark has become a Christian nation, and pastors were paid by the government, and they are preaching the message as a followers of Luther. Basically, they said, well, other part of Europe follows Calvin, but we follow Luther, and we believe in sola fide, sola scriptura, only scripture, only faith. So we don't really have to do anything to be saved. You're born as a Christian. If you're Danish, born in Denmark, we are Christian. So they declare Christianity as their own, which against that young man, Kierkegaard said, hell no. He said, it's not a group activity. Faith in Christ is an individual thing. You need to encounter God. You need to meet God. You need to have fellowship. You need to have relationship with living God, right? So in this Christian discourse, it's divided into four sections. And Pastor Lee Chang-woo that I met in Korea, Sejong City, he is now translated Christian discourse, one book, into four sections, into four parts. And this is one of them. And I read 2.5 books in Korea at this time, 3 weeks I spent there, and so thoroughly enjoyed. So I'm going to go sharing Kierkegaard in all the book talks from now on. So if you're listening to this, wow, rejoice. You're going to become Soren Kierkegaard expert by end of all my book talk, because you probably go through all the books that Kierkegaard has ever wrote. So this is an introduction. I couldn't even finish, just barely finished introduction and part one of chapter one of this book. If you are a Kierkegaard scholar, you would know the name Howard and Edna Hong. Howard Hong was born at North Dakota, October 19, 1912. He died at age 97 after translating everything that Soren Kierkegaard has ever written, including little memo on the napkin. And that's kind of an ongoing joke at St. Olaf University. I studied there for a week and then met all these people. And he's been teaching there since late 30s. Translate everything. So, wow. I'm trying to buy the whole volume through Kindle, and it was $687. So I said, oh no, I'm going to hunt down the used bookstores and find translation, because there are many, many translations, but Edna Hong and Howard Hong translate everything. In this Christian discourse, into four sections, and this is part one section of Christian discourse. And the question they raise is Christian discourse on the cares of the pagans. Cares of the pagans. Translator, Pastor Lee, whom I met at Sejong City, he was so impressive. He was such a purist. He spent last 10 years translating Kierkegaard's book by learning English and learning Danish. Because all the transcription, actually, English transcription or translation is published, posted through Kierkegaard Institute of Copenhagen. So if you ever go there, then you could just download and read. So what he did was he would read it, and then he would listen to a lecture by John Stuart at that institute, the best lecturer, the authority figure in Kierkegaard these days. And then, because he doesn't really understand English, he would listen to several times, and he would actually translate it, the transcript of the lecture, so that he could understand, and wrote this extensive comment on this particular book. He writes, the pagan that Kierkegaard talks about in this Christian discourse is not about pagan necessarily, but Christians who think they are Christian in Denmark. You see, it was book written against Christians in Denmark. So when you read this book in English, and you wouldn't think like, well, he's just saying that, well, you cannot be Christian as a group. Now, in the context of Denmark saying that if you're born as Danish, you're Christian automatically, yes, it is anti, in a way, government book. It's anti popular teaching, just like I'm so against prosperity gospel. It was anti the popular theology of the day. Popular theology was that, well, sola fide is by faith only. So you don't have to do anything to be saved. Just born as Danish by faith, well, by believing that you are born as Danish as a Christian, you're going to be saved. He's saying, hell no, you're going to die and go to hell. So strong words, you know. So he's totally against Danish thought at the time, that if you're born as Danish, you are Christian and you're heaven bound. And he's bringing in the beatitude. Chapter 5, 6, 7, he talks about how God bring the gospel, the good news to his people. And he opens up by a prayer saying that, Lord, speak to your people through, and then in this beautiful poetry, and then brings Matthew chapter 6, verse, let me read. He brings beautiful text. Matthew 6:24-34. He says, look at the birds in the air. They do not plant or have warehouse, and yet God feeds them. His argument is this. Moses received the law at the top of the mountain, but Jesus comes down from the mountain at the foot of the mountain. He proclaims the gospel. And this, in a way, is related, the law and the gospel. But when he was proclaiming the gospel, he said, behold the bird, as a symbolism, as like a PowerPoint presentation of what it means to be saved. And he said, he writes, if you live like the bird, then you are surely Christian indeed. And he says, the bird does not worry. So if you do not worry about what to wear, what to eat, then you are indeed Christian. But if you worry, if you cares, if you have the cares of the pagan, then you are pagan indeed. You're not saved. That is a strong statement. And so he's saying that don't talk about, I mean, now I'm paraphrasing, and this is Kierkegaard coming out of me as I talking to people. Don't talk about when you receive Christ, when you're seventh grade at a retreat. No, talk about what Jesus and you are doing today because you follow Christ. And one of them is, obviously, the true Christians do not care about today. Caring meaning that only the pagans would care about today. And if you worry about today, what to wear, what to eat, and constantly have focus about that, then you may not be Christian, or my term would be doubt your salvation. Don't assume that you are. Cares of poverty. Because Kierkegaard, in his book, talks about salvation from anxiety. Anxiety of future, anxiety. And so anxiety was translated into fear in Korean. But he's saying fear and anxiety, whether it's fear or anxiety, we should not have anxiety if you are experiencing the salvation daily. He brings out the whole concept of daily. So the whole Christian discourse talks about then how can we live our Christian life based on or in the thought of anxiety. If you read Beatitude in Matthew 5, Jesus ends the Matthew 5 by stating, be holy as God is holy. Pretty much asking us to do that is impossible, right? I'm trying to be just a nice guy. And he says, no, that's not enough. You must be holy as God is holy. And then you tell yourself, well, that's not possible. Why do we even try? He says, okay, then chapter 16. Well, what about this, folks? Then why don't you look at the bird that's flying? Look at the lily of the valley. Why don't you be like that? Isn't it more approachable, more doable? And you can think to yourself like, okay, maybe that's doable, right? That's more doable. That's what Kierkegaard is saying. That God is telling us to live like that bird flying. The bird has no cares. He doesn't have a barn. He doesn't collect food overnight. I mean, this is apparent, you know, because in Cambodian context, they're Buddhist and they value all the life living things. So some rich folks, you know, we noticed that our next door neighbor, quite rich, with several nice cars, would always bring rice in front of their house for sparrows to come and eat. Now, you don't find sparrows eating more than he needs or tree branches and say, no, they don't. They just eat daily, and they don't really worry. They fly, they don't store. And so he's saying that you do not, your definition of holiness is that you must go beyond the fear and anxiety of the world. And you must experience daily, you must to be experience this daily salvation through daily prayer, and in our context, daily gospel, right? And Kierkegaard challenges, pray to save you from this daily evil. Don't pray for yesterday's evil, it's already too late. Don't pray for tomorrow's evil because it hasn't come. Pray for, save us from today's evil. That's Kierkegaard. Now you see how a lot of my teaching has come out of Kierkegaard all this time that you're listening to me. And first thing that the birds don't do is they don't worry about what to eat. Why? Because God created the warehouse in heaven. You know, it's literally true. If you really watch birds flying, they do not fly. They zigzag and all that. Why? Because God provide all these flying insects in heaven, in the sky, right? That's the key point. We Christians should not worry that our livelihood, as we live, God will provide. And you'll be faithful, right? You'll be faithful to all that that God has given. But we don't worry about what to eat, what to wear today. Boy, that was a long introduction. I don't know how long, how many times I'll be doing this book talk. But yeah, if you could get Christian Discourses by Søren Kierkegaard, it's available at Amazon. The Howard and Edna Holm translation is very expensive. It's collector's item. So now it's like something like $45, but you don't have to do that. You could go to used book section and I found something for $8. So, but I've been collecting Kierkegaard most of my life. So I do have a lot of volumes and wrote a few books on Kierkegaard, but if you could get it, that would be fantastic. If I could buy in Kindle and then follow along, it would be great, because I'll be covering about the cares of pagans, care of poverty, care of abundance, care of lowliness, care of loftiness, care of presumptuousness, care of self-torment, care of indecisiveness, 7 sections through this book talk. Amen. Lord bless you. I'll see you tomorrow. Love you guys. Mwah.